Hello everyone, this is video. I show how to create the password field, show and hide the password using FlatLaf look and feel, and we learn how to custom this with the animated icon. Now let's get started. Here I have create project in IntelliJ, and in pom.xml file, I has added the dependency for this project, like FlatLaf, FlatLaf extras, and miglayout. And we also use the FlatLaf fonts Roboto, so we add this. And here we have mainframe for run. I has write some code, like we set the frame size and set the frame layout. And this class has extends from JFrame. And in this main method here, we install the FlatLaf look and feel and register the FlatLaf style properties. For the FlatLaf properties I has created in the resources folder here, here I has some custom style for the password field and button. And we have the eye icon as the CG file. So now we can run this project. Here we get the empty frame. So next we're gonna create the password field and one J button on this frame. We can use MIG layout option, so width we use 250 and create one sample button. For the width we also use 250. Let run it. Here we got one sample password field and one sample J button. But for this button, I want to make it as the default button. So we need to override the method is default button, then return true. Then we need to show the password reveal button. So in FlatLaf, we use the method putClient property to apply the style to the component. We use the style show reveal button and set it to true. Let run it. Here we get the reveal button and we can click it to show and hide the password. So next we're gonna create the custom the icon. Now create new package as icon. And in this icon package, we create the custom icon class, so we call it password reveal icon. Then implements this class from animated icon interface. And we need override the all abstract method. Now we need implement the method that we has override in this class. So first we create the icon object and we need the constructor. And we need one more constructor as the default constructor. In this constructor, we initialize the icon with class flat SVG icon, then provide this location of the icon. And here we need to assign the parameter icon to the instance icon. Now we have the icon object in this custom password icon class. Next, go to method paint icon animated and use icon.paintIcon to paint the icon graphics to this custom class. And this for method get value we will implement later, but for the method get icon width, we need return the width of the icon. And also for the method get icon height, we return the height of the icon. So next we can apply this icon to the password field by go to the file FlatLaf properties and add one property as password field.reveal icon. So how to make the custom icon class as the value in the FlatLaf property? Here we use the class name with the package name of the icon class that we has created. Now we can run it. We can see the eye icon, but it's too large. So I want to make it a little smaller. In the FlatSVG icon class, there is an additional parameter for the scale value. By default, it is set to 1, but we can decrease it to 1.75. But we need custom this button style, like we want to remove the selection background or hover background. By go to FlatLaf file properties again and create the FlatLaf style class, and this style we apply to toggle button, and here the class name as reveal button. But why we need to create this style class? Here I want to show you by go to FlatLaf GitHub repository and go to FlatLaf core project. In search box here, we search for the class flat password field UI. Here we see it. Then find the method as create reveal button by press key control F. Let me zoom a little bit. Here we see the method create reveal button and we have the J toggle button object here. And here we see the style class that apply to this toggle button, in text field, and reveal button. So when we create reveal button style class, these style will apply to this toggle button. Now back to FlatLaf style properties and create style that we want. First here, we change the border and remove the selected background, but we use the toolbar style because toggle button and text field use the toolbar button style properties. And also remove the hover background and press background. In a properties file, when defining a multi-line value, you need to use a backslash at the end of each line to indicate that the value continues on to the next line. Now we can run it. Here the style has applied to this button. So next we're going to make the animation to this icon when we click on it. Go to password RevealIcon class and in method paintIcon animated here. First we need to create the graphics 2D object. We need to dispose the graphics object here. And then we can change this to G2 object. Next we check if the animated value greater than 0, so we go to paint the graphics. Here create the start X and start Y for the line location at the start point. And here for the end of the line location. So when we have the start point and the end point, now we can create the shape object from these point. We use the line 2D class to create the line, then pass the value and we need calculate with the animated value. Now we has create the line 2D shape. So we need to draw this line to the graphics. But I create new method to draw it. So in this method, we has parameter graphics 2D, shape object that we want to draw, color for the line color and the size for the line size. Now set the color to this graphics 2D object. Then change the line size so in the graphics 2D object, we use method set stroke and new with the basic stroke. Then pass the size value with the method UI scale. And set the basic stroke option as cap round and join round to make the line border round. Then draw the shape object. So now we can call this method to draw the shape that we create. So we pass graphics, shape, color, and line size. For the line size, we set 1.5. And for the method get value, we need to return the value. So when the button is selected, we return 0. And if not selected, we return 1. Now we can run it. Here we have the line with animation, but it is too long, so we need decrease a little bit. So go at the top. Here we need create new variable. We can call it a space, and also add it in the constructor. Then initialize it with 3 for the default. And then we need use it in method paintIcon animated. First we need scale this value with the method UI scale. Then change all this value. Now we can run it. Now, it looks good. Let me change the resolution to see the line details in the graphics that has draw. Here, change this to 50. We can see the graphics draw not smooth. So to improve the graphics draw smoothly, we need set the graphics rendering hint. Now we can run it. It looks good. Now we need draw one more line behind this line. Here just call the method drawLine in here and pass the graphics object shape. But for the color, we use the parent background. So this will be the password field background color. And for the size we set as 4. Now we can run it. Here now it looked good. We can test it. So the line has draw when the password is hide, so we can change it if we want to draw the line when the password is showing. Here just change the value and method, get value here. We change this to 1 and this to 0. Now we see the line has draw when the password is showing. But I change it back, just to show you if you want to change this icon option. Thank you everyone for watching. If you found this tutorial helpful, please like the video and subscribe for more content.